That was a delayed one too. Absolutely dreadful, still. Launched into that next attack really fast. I tapped the roll key, but nothing. Yeah. This guy. I knew the archers were going to catch up to me as soon as the first guy knocked me down on the floor for so long. Here we go. Yeah, he was just acting just that little bit faster than he was before. Once he goes flaming sword mode, he just seems to speed up just that little fraction. Often casts me out, zero stamina. Pressed the roll key. It wasn't the same time he stabbed me. So I guess it wasn't early enough. Well, I don't think this is happening. I'm gonna try my hunch that I had about the king. Or more like, I wonder if this is how we get to the king. Hello there. Just tried a few more tries against Smelter Demon. No luck. A few last night, a few this morning. Nothing. But I did have an idea about the king. I think the queen, right, if she's an evil queen, she's got him in the dungeon. And although I looked everywhere else, I didn't try looking in one place in the castle. So hopefully this will pan out. Yeah, how are you? Are you having a good morning? Alright, awesome. So my plan was this. I thought maybe this would be a dungeon that the queen had put the king in, but it's not. Unless I need to activate the other golem that I didn't. I think that activating this one opened up the castle door. I don't think I ever activated this one. It's possible. I'll try killing all of these guys and even the elephant men. They just made it too hard for someone who didn't put in billions of health. I still think health is the most boring thing in the world. So that's never going to be me. If any gameplay requires me to have billions of health put in, then it's just going to be impossible for me forever. I decided I couldn't be bothered with him too much, so kicking him off is fair game at this point. Looking for this irritating king. So two things. I'm not normally invaded by a spirit here. And there seems to be like a white wall on the castle now. I'm gonna have to investigate that, but that looks really weird down there. It's like a truck. Oh. Kind of wish the NPCs had some sort of stamina instead of just being able to go ham forever. Gotcha! Oof. Oh, the White Wall was part of, you know, that invasion. It's gone again now. Okay. Yeah, I think the scythe does look really, really nice. Initially, I was saying, like, oh, my Dark Souls 1 ended too easily because I ended up with the long weapon, so I was just going to go with short weapons this time around. It started off with quite a short axe, but then this axe is kind of cool. So, eh, just evolved into another long weapon. Hasn't really helped me just win too easily, though, I can say. I can safely say, though, I still hate group fights. I just, I don't see how Dark Souls 2 could be, you know, how somebody could design the game and say, well, that's fun to have two of those just walk in tandem at you. If you ever try to attack one of them, they'll both hit you. And it's impossible to dodge one and just hit one. It's just... it drives me mad. I'd literally need some kind of spell that's of like a spell of hold creature to hold one so I could properly fight the other. Oh yeah, I spent a long time fighting those guys. It was just like, if it was just one, I could have a decent try, but the way that they're completely independently swinging weapons at you is just, it just borders on the impossible. I just wish the first one physically blocked the weapon strike of the second one. That's the only thing that makes sense to me. Like, you know, they should be impassable terrain for each other. I've actually played incredibly far through Monster Hunter World. Point that I would say I completed the original version of the game and like the first patch maybe that brought out another monster. There was this like dragon made of gold where you kind of beat a bit of it and then you just get these declarations about how other parties have defeated a bit of it as well, and I gave up at that patch. Just a little bit of a chore to get all the gold items. Yeah, everything before that I beat with the musical instrument club weapon. And then eventually I got bored of the hassle of doing the combos on that. So then I went lance. That's the one, the hunting horn. I was a hunting horn grandmaster. My save is absolutely complete. Yeah. I feel like it was super challenging as well, because I ended up doing like a lot of solo stuff with the hunting horn. And it's not great for by yourself. But the idea was that I was going to be playing with like a load of the friends, but they didn't play so much. Yeah, it's fun going around and getting everything. And I really did like that because it was generally like a one-on-one. Not a lot of other things engaged you. It's kind of cool sometimes when it did run through a bunch of other things. I quite like the Diablos kind of dragony enemies. And then when I got to like the more new game plush-ish kind of thing, or New World Plus or whatever they wanted to call it, I even quite liked hunting the little poison guy that's more like the starting thing. Yeah, when there's multiple monsters battling each other, that's awesome. I feel like they play that up a lot more when it new game pluses. Shield guys are kind of annoying when they just back up forever, and when you finally come at them, they just, you know, insta-stop the block and go quite mad. Oh man, I was so sure this was gonna do something. Oh, how wrong I was. That was the door one, I think, that opened. Or maybe this was the door one. Either way, I didn't hear any kind of sound effect that signified that this is opened. Damn it all.